Thanks, Denny. Well, this is where you'll find a radiator, and this is what it looks like. And here's how it works.
In physics, you'll learn how the cooling system carries off the heat.
A car's engine generates a lot of heat from the internal combustion that creates its energy. Unless that heat has somewhere to go, it will simply build up in your engine and cause severe damage to engine parts. The radiator transfers that heat out into the air, but in order to do that, the heat has to have a way of getting there. That's where the coolant, somewhat confusingly known as antifreeze, comes in. This fluid is a mixture of water, dye, and a chemical called glycol. Ethylene and propylene glycol not only help prohibit freezing, they also increase the fluid's boiling point and help transfer heat. As the hot coolant circulates through the radiator core, heat is conducted to the outer surface made up of hundreds of these aluminum fins and dissipated into the air. Now, as you can imagine, having a lot of water and glycol sitting inside a lot of metal with temperature extremes over time is a formula for corrosion. Now, your service technician can detect the amount of corrosion with these pH strips. Now, if the word corrosion doesn't cause you to stop and think of it as dissolved engine. And when the flow of this coolant in your radiator is choked off by a buildup of corrosive deposits, your engine will overheat, and that means you can burn up a lot of money with it.